We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time, we are looking at Detective Comics number 982. This is a self-contained story. It's sort of in between story arcs. It's what they used to call a fill-in issue. This is called The Cursing of Gotham City, written by Michael Moreci, Sebastian Fiumara, artist, Dave Stewart, colors, Clem Robbins, letters, Sebastian Fiumara, and Brad Anderson, cover. I really like that cover. That is an awesome cover. Dave Walgoes and Chris Conroy were the editors, Jamie S. Rich, group editor. Now, like I said, this is a self-contained issue, but that doesn't make it bad. In fact, this is about Deacon Blackfire returning from the dead. Batman had thought the Spectre had obliterated Deacon several years back, but now Blackfire's gotten into Batman's head and he's trying to convince him to give in to Blackfire's vision of tearing down Gotham so he can rebuild it anew. Unfortunately, Blackfire also has a kid named Joshua who is a descendant hostage, and that's what Batman's after. Batman has to overcome his demons internally and externally to try and free Joshua and save the day. All in all, this is a fantastic issue. There's a pretty good speech by Batman in here that's a little long, but otherwise really, really good. It shows a lot of Batman's motivations and his inner strength, and it was a fantastic book. The art style is a little heavier on pencils than I generally like, but it really worked out here because it's really adding to the darkness of the overall theme of the book. So I did enjoy the art, even though it's not a style I typically enjoy. The scenes of Gotham looked really cool, and a lot of Batman looked really good. So overall, a solid issue. This is a definite recommend. I enjoyed this quite a bit, and I would like to see this author and artist do some more work on Detective Comics. I think they could be really good for a darker tone and some really interesting themes. But for a one-issue story, this was fantastic. So this is well worth the cover price, which is rare, and I was glad I picked this one up. It was a nice breath of fresh air in the Detective Comics continuity. The last storyline was pretty good, but this one you didn't need a bunch of backstory for. You could just grab it, read it, and go. You didn't have to know all the background. You didn't have to know a whole bunch of other nonsense that's interrelated to what's going on. Less soap opera nonsense. And it's self-contained, which is great. I would love to see more Batman books like that, but, you know, that's really not something we get anymore. That being said, this is a must have for any good Batman collector, I think, and that's just my opinion. So that's gonna do it for this one. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.